Okay, we've got some breaking news coming in from Ladakh. As a matter of fact, the latest talks to resolve the India-China standoff have just taken place. Big news coming in from Ladakh. India and China have just held their third high-level talks at the army level. Two major generals, one from the Indian side and one from the Chinese side, have met just a short while ago in Ladakh to try and defuse the standoff. But the bad news is this happens to be the third meeting by major generals of both sides. There were meetings that were held earlier in May. So this is the third meeting at the major general level. And all eyes are now on the outcome of today's Ladakh meeting. It's been a full month since the standoff began. Abhishek Balla, defense editor, breaking this news here on India Today. Abhishek, several different military meetings between the Indian and Chinese have taken place in Ladakh at the commanding officer level, at the brigadier level, and two meetings have already taken place at the major general level. Today's was that third meeting, Abhishek. Any indicators so far on the outcome? Everybody is going to be wondering, so many meetings, when will there be results?
That's the big question, Shiv, that everybody wants to know. And, you know, unfortunately, there are no answers. There have been several rounds of meetings at different levels as far as military commanders are concerned. We believe that at a diplomatic level, there is also a dialogue happening simultaneously. But the fact remains that, you know, not much has changed despite these meetings taking place. Both sides are extremely hopeful that it is only a dialogue that can get a breakthrough. But as far as the ground situation is concerned, the troop buildup continues to be how it was. Both sides are in a sense, you know, they are very much in a position of confrontation even now. There have also been scuffles in the last 29 days. Fortunately, what we heard last was that those kind of scuffles have stopped at least for the last 3-4 days, and there's no fresh violence. That's what army sources told us. But the situation remains extremely tense with both sides in a position of confrontation.
Okay, can't wait to hear what the results of that third major general level meeting are. Abhishek will, of course, bring it to us once the update is in from Ladakh. Thanks very much, Abhishek, for getting us the latest on that. Meanwhile, the Congress party has hit out at the Modi government over the India-China border face-off. Attacking the center, Congress leader Manish Tiwari has said that the government is hiding facts and peddling lies and saying that China has occupied 40 to 60 square kilometers of Indian territory while the government was asleep. That's what Manish Tiwari is saying. He's also called it an intelligence failure on the line of actual control. Meanwhile, Congress spokesperson Randeep Singh Surjewala has brought up a 2014 tweet of Amit Shah, which questioned the erstwhile Congress government over inaction against China. Hitting out at Shah, Surjewala said, "Why is the Home Minister not speaking out now on Chinese aggression?"
I'm a little bit worried that the seriousness with which it should be handled is not apparent, at least is not apparent in the government's conduct. We had the Chinese president on a swing in Gujarat with our Prime Minister. So if that is something that we have tried to achieve, why is it that we can't talk to each other about any disagreement?
Anand Patel live with me. Anand, is this India-China face-off and standoff in Ladakh going to precipitate into a bigger political issue? The Congress has just sort of woken up to it in a bigger way. They've latched onto it via Manish Tiwari. Is it likely to snowball into a larger face-off between the opposition and the government?
Well, yes, you know, Shiv, the manner in which the standoff has taken a serious turn now, the Congress party is going all out to embarrass the government in domestic politics. Take it, you know, right from Rahul Gandhi's press conference last week, in which he said the government should be transparent in what it is doing in Ladakh at LSE. Manish Tiwari also tweeted and said the transgressions have come in to at least 40 to 80 square kilometers into the Indian side. Randeep Surjewala tweeted the 2014 tweet of Amit Shah, when he was in the opposition just ahead of the Lok Sabha, questioning the government silence. So it's come to haunt back to the BJP, the situation at LAC. Clearly, the pictures which have emerged in the international media, the kind of reports which are coming, the opposition thinks that the government is not taking the political parties into confidence. And since these are matters of international security, national importance, and the kind of situation which is building it up there, people like, you know, even Asuddin Owaisi are saying that 4,000 to 5,000 Chinese have come into Indian side.
The thing is, so far the government has not commented on it. The only thing we've got so far is a few comments from a few ministers and the Ministry of External Affairs, but nothing concrete and no specifics so far on this, even though the Raksha Mantri, the Defence Minister, has also spoken and assured Indians that there's nothing to be worried about. We'll have to see where that actually goes politically.
Hi everyone, Preeti Chaudhary here. Hope you like this video. For latest news and analysis, like and subscribe to the India Today YouTube channel. And don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated. Thank you for watching.